Good afternoon, all of you.
Good afternoon.
This is Dr. Naysar. Welcome you once again in the online lecture series of information system. This is our lecture number 7. And today we are going to discuss about the information system manager and various kind of challenges being faced by the information system manager. All of you can able to see the screen? Yes?
Yes,
sir. Yes. Okay, last time what we have discussed?
Challenges in development of information system.
Various kind of challenges in the development of information system. So we have seen the two main categorization, which are that? Two main challenges.
Operational.
Operational challenges and the?
Technical challenges.
Technical challenges. Under the operational, which challenges we have discussed?
Bad communication.
Then
unclear requirement,
very good.
Increasing cost,
good.
Delay project delivery and market pressure.
Yes. And under the technical challenges,
knowing technical need.
Okay, next.
Quality control. Security.
Okay, so up till most of the things related with the information system we have studied, this is the last point from this unit, and after this, on whatever point we have discussed, we have the two case studies. Okay, on the case study also question being asked number of times, so we will also discuss the case studies also. Okay, now today's our point of discussion is the information system manager and his challenges. Okay, so all of you must be knowing what we have discussed regarding the what is information system challenges during the development of information system, component of the information system, role of the information system, examples, this all the things already we have discussed. Okay, now consider the information system is available in certain industry. Okay, certain industries utilizing the information system. Okay, consider any XYZ company who is utilizing the information system. Okay, now to manage that information system, is there need of some person, yes or no?
Yes,
yes. Even there is a computerized installed information system is there. There need of some employee, some person who will control, manage that information system. And so there, that person we are referring as what? The information system manager. Correct?
What kutti? Swara kutti.
Do. Sanjara Pardeshi. Who is this? Sanjara Pardeshi.
Sorry, sir.
You know I am recording this video. Shall I remove you?
Sorry, sir.
Okay, so to do all these kind of activities, okay, to control the information system, maintain the information system, update the information system, the person who is there, that person is nothing but we are calling as what? The information system manager. All of you got this point? Yes?
Yes.
And related to that, for example, any person, employee who is being working as a manager there, what kind of challenges he has to face related with that information system, that is nothing but our point of discussion today. Okay. So today in the business environment has been drastically changed. If you compare the today's business environment with the business environment of 20 years back, now there is a huge changes has been occurred. Okay. And those who is working as an information system manager there, he don't have to just manage the equipments. For example, if you take the example, information system is getting utilized in some software company. Okay. Information system is getting utilized in some software company. Okay. Any company can utilize the information system for their work. We are considering the information system is getting utilized by some software company. So that software, that particular information system manager has just not need to manage the equipments which are there. Equipments can be the computers, etc., or other equipments. He just not having the duty of managing the equipments or data or other system, but there are others, various kind of challenges also he has to perform. Understood? Which are that others kind of challenges? One of that is the cross training. We are discussing the information system manager challenges. What do you mean by the cross training? Yes, anybody can tell me? Cross training means what? One of the challenge being faced by the information system manager. Yes, anybody? Do you understand what I am asking? Yes.
Yes, sir.
What do you mean by the cross training? Okay, cross training in the sense, suppose you have hired the employee for one work in your company. Okay, you are getting situation, you have hired or you have taken one employee in your company to do some work. Okay, for example, in the software company, you have hired the one particular employee as a programmer. Okay, getting situation?
Yes? Yes, sir.
You have hired one employee to do the programming. But when that particular employee or the person, that person is given a training of testing. What? Testing. I hope you must be aware coding and the testing. Software testing, yes?
Yes, sir.
Programming, that is they're doing coding of the program and testing of the program or the software. These are the two different things. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And what I'm telling you, person you have hired for doing the programming, the manager gives the training to that particular employee of software testing also. Got the situation?
Yes, sir.
That is nothing but called as what, the cross training. This happens in number of companies. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So do you understand the point of cross training?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then manager also has to do the personal management, means management of the workers or the employee who is working under him. That is the personal management. Then he has also need to perform the duty of interdepartmental communication. Interdepartmental communication means what? Yes, anybody? Interdepartmental communication? What do you mean by the interdepartmental communication? Okay, you must have heard the word inter. Just the inter okay, and the intra. Okay, what is difference between these two words? The inter, just this inter and the intra. Yes, anybody? What is the meaning of the word inter and the intra? Yes, Yogesh, what do you mean by the inter and the intra? Tejas, what is the meaning of inter? INTER.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Inter means between two groups, or intra means inside one group.
Exactly. Very good. What is being said here? Manager also has to perform the duty of interdepartmental communication. Ata software company madhe vegvegle department, pratyek industry madhe vegvegle department astat barobar, sales department, maintenance department, okay, product delivery department, billing department, etc., etc. Interdepartment means the manager also need to perform the communication of one department with the another department. Understood? So interdepartmental communication is nothing but the communication of one department with the another department. Okay. And intradepartmental means communication within a same department only. Understood? So these are some important issues which is we are considering as a challenges being faced by the information system manager. These are the some general challenges. Okay. And today we are going to discuss some specific problem or the challenges being faced by the information system manager in the industry. Okay. And in that, first we have first problem being faced, tough data flow. Yes. Can anybody tell me about this? What do you think about the tough data flow? Yes. Okay, the communication must be two-way. It should not happen like that. I am speaking from this side and you are just listening. Correct. Tough data flow in the sense. Yes, Tejas. What do you think? Anybody? Data flow in the sense there is a changes happening in the data, correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Changes happening in the data, that is nothing but the data flow. Now whatever the information being available with certain industry, that information always in the strong fluctuation mode. What that information is always in the strong fluctuation mode means what? Yes, strong fluctuation of the information means what? Very fastly the information is getting updated, yes or no? That is nothing but what? Strong fluctuation of the data or the information. Yes, got this point?
Yes, sir.
Very fastly, the changes in the information happening. That is nothing but the meaning of strong fluctuation of the information. Now, this all changing information, the old information getting updated as a new information, the thing which is very important here is nothing but the controlling of that information with the help of information system. Then what exactly mean by the controlling of the information? So controlling of that information is nothing but analyzing and the evaluation of that information with the help of information system available in your industry. Okay, now what do you mean by the analyzing and the evolution of the information with the help of information system? Now you tell me about this. We got the question. Yes.
No.
What I ask, the controlling of the information is nothing but what? Analyzing the information and evaluation of the information with the help of what? Information system. Then what I am asking, what do you mean by the analyzing and evaluation of the information with the help of the information system? Yes, Tejas.
Hello.
Yes. What do you mean by the analyzing the information? What do you mean by analyzing the information? Analyzing and evaluation of the information. Okay. You must be able to see this.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Analyzing and evolution of, evaluation of the information. Analyze and evaluation is nothing but what? Processing of the information. Correct or not?
Yes.
Processing of the information available. Available or the information which is getting updated. Now, to analyze and evaluate that information, what tool we are having in the company?
People's,
but to analyze and evaluate that information automatically, we are using one tool. That is what? That is nothing but our information system. Correct or not? Okay. So controlling the information is nothing but the analyzing and evaluating that information is nothing but processing of that information with the help of the information system, which is available within your company. Understood. So that is nothing but what we are popularly referring it as a processing of the electronic data. Correct? Okay. Electronic data means what? Yes, all of you can hear me. What do you mean by the electronic data? Vaishali, what is mean by the electronic data?
Sir, ATM card, like ATM card.
Electronic data means what?
Programs.
Means that is the kind of data which is being getting processed on some electronic devices. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Correct.
Yes,
so,
sir.
Whatever the data being processed using some electronic device, the ATM also process some data of the card. That is also you can call the electronic data. But here, our information system is also the one electronic device that is the running on one some electronic device that is the computer. Okay. And controlling of the information is nothing but what? Or handling the fluctuation of the information is nothing but what? Analyzing and evaluation. That is nothing but the processing of that information with the help of the information system. Understood. And to achieve this task of controlling of information, that is nothing but the processing of the information utilizing the information system, it is required that manager should tell their employees or manager should make their employees aware of the importance of that particular data and the information collected in the company. Yes or no? Yes.
Yes, sir.
So the manager should encourage their employee what is the importance of that data and the information is that data and information which is available in their company. Understood. And manager should also tell them to analyze that information and data with the help of the information system. Whether that analysis and the evaluation will happen automatically? Yes, it will happen automatically. But is there any need of some employee to input that particular kind of data to the information system? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, that data need to be the input to that system. Okay. in particular proper way, then and then only analysis and evolution of that information will happen. And so duty of manager here is what? To encourage their employee, to tell their employee what is the actually the importance of data, importance of the particular data and the information they are having with them. Understood? If the data and the information available with the company is not get processed, is not get analyzed, is not get evaluated, is there utilization of that data and information to that company? Yes. Do you understand the question, what I'm asking? Shall I repeat?
Yes, sir.
What I'm asking, data and information available with the company. Okay. If that data and information is not get processed, is there use of that data and information to that company?
No.
No. So to get better utilization of that data and information, it is need to be processed with the help of what? The information system. Understood? And to assign that duty to that employee, to tell that employee what is the importance of that data and the information, etc., and encourage them to utilize the information system, that is nothing but the one of the major challenge of information system manager. And that is we are referring it as what? Tough data flow as one of the challenge being faced by what? Information system manager. So tough data flow is nothing but what? Managing or handling the continuously changing data with the help of the information system. That is nothing but what? First challenge of information system manager. Yes, all of you understood the first challenge?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
yes sir.
So let me tell you one example. All of you must be known about the Cotton King cloth store.
Yes, sir.
Cotton King, famous brand is there. Okay. Cotton King cloth store. Now consider that Cotton King cloth store is having the information system in their shop. Correct?
Yes.
And now Cotton King, after some month, they launch one new product in their they introduce a new brand related with some cloth, correct? On the event of Diwali festival, what they do? They introduce the new brand of cloth, correct?
Yes.
Now how the information system available within that shop can be better utilized related with newly introduced brand of cloth? Yes. Do you understand the question? Situation? Or shall I repeat?
Yes, sir. Repeat.
Okay. What I said, Cotton King. Okay. There is a Cotton King shop is there. Cotton King shop, what they are running? They are selling the clothes, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. Forget about the Cotton King. Consider our Kapse Paitani. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Kapse Paitani, correct. Now, Kapse Paitani has introduced new Paitani during the Diwali festival, okay?
Yes, sir.
And the Kapse Paitani, that their showroom is having the one information system in their showroom. Okay.
Okay.
How this information system can be utilized by the Kapse Paitani showroom related with new Paitani they are going to launch? Yes.
showing some ads.
Yes, yes. What?
Showing some ads related to Python.
Ad. Do you want to see the ad?
Yes.
Tejas, yes, Tejas. What do you want to say?
Ads देते सर दे papers में
कहाँ ad कुनाला information system चाहिए यूज़ ते कैसा कर दिल that is I am asking yes
हेलो सर
हाँ यस सूरज हाँ
सर जो तेरे प्रीवियस कस्टमर से डेटा कलेक्ट के लिए लास्ट
वेरी गुड वेरी गुड दैट इज आई एम आस्किंग
मैसेज हुआ कैसे नहीं तेरी
बरोबर त्या इन्फॉर्मेशन सिस्टम चा यूज करून ते सगळ्यांना त्याचे अपडेट पाठवू शकतील करेक्ट
हो सर
की दे हैव लॉन्च वन न्यू पैटर्न ऑन द इवेंट ऑफ दिस Diwali festival. So that is nothing but the better utilization of the data and information available with the company. Correct?
Yes, sir.
And that is nothing but the handling, one example of handling the data and the information available with certain company or for example, we have taken the example of Paitani showroom. Understood. So that is the one thing, one challenge being faced by the information system manager that we are referring it as a first tough data flow is nothing but managing, analyzing and evaluation of the data information available with them with the help of the information system. Okay. Shall we go to the next challenge?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Second important is rising cost. This is very much important. Second important challenge being faced by information system manager is rising cost. Yes. Rising cost. Rising cost in the sense what? Increase in the costing. Okay. Can you tell me what is the relationship between the profit and the increase in the cost of certain company? All of you got the question? Yes. Suraj. Tejas. Yes,
yes, sir.
What is the relation between increase in the rising in the cost and profit of the company?
प्रॉफिट म्हणजे सर समजा आपण एखादी पैठणी म्हणजे
रिलेशन
विणकराकडून विकत घेतली रिलेशन समजा आपण एखादी पैठणी विणकराकडून घेतली म्हणजे माल त्याने घेतली आणि त्याने एखाद्या कस्टमरला विकली बाहेर तर सेलिंग प्राइस आणि कॉस्ट प्राइस मध्ये जो डिफरन्स असेल तो प्रॉफिट असेल म्हणजे त्याला जेवढं
भेटली म्हणजे आय एम नॉट आस्किंग दॅट आय एम आस्किंग रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन प्रॉफिट ऑफ द कंपनी अँड रायझिंग कॉस्ट I am asking the relation.
Cost widely, the profit come you will company.
Exactly, that is nothing but the relationship. Simple. If the cost of the developing the product rises, definitely profit will come down. If the cost get decreased, definitely the profit will increase. Understood. So managing these rising cost is nothing but the second challenge faced by the information system manager. Understood. Now how actually it happens, let's see. Now most of the industry experts have done the survey. What the survey they have done? Various old system which are existing in the company get utilized only 30% of their optimal performance. Means what? Suppose in your company, now in our department also you can think about, consider the example of some software company. They are having the 100 PCs available with them. How many? 100 PCs available with them. 100 computers or the laptop, correct? XYZ company is having XYZ company is having the 100 laptop in their company, correct? Yes. And out of that 100, only 40 are getting utilized most of the time. What? Out of that 100, only the 40 is getting utilized most of the time. Then remaining 60 is nothing but what? They are not getting utilized. Correct. They are not getting utilized. And if some resources available in your company and they are not getting utilized 100%, then that is nothing but what? That is nothing but what? Decrease in the optimal performance of resources available within your company. You understood what I'm saying?
Yes.
If all of the laptops are not getting utilized, then what is the use of having the 100 laptops within a company? Correct. If out of the 100, only 40 are getting utilized, means only the utilization percentage is how much? 40% only. What is about the remaining 60%? So remaining 60% are just not getting utilized. Means what we can say from that, the resources which is available within a company are not getting fully utilized. Correct or not?
Correct.
Now you tell me what do you mean by the resources of the what are the different resources available within a XYZ software company? What are the resources of some XYZ software company? Yes, Tejas. What is meant by the resources?
Raw materials.
I am asking about raw some materials. Software industry.
Software. Staff.
Human beings are the resources. The human employee utilizing the computers to work, laptop, they are also the resources, correct or not?
Yes.
Various kind of software they are utilizing, various tools they are utilizing, various hardware devices they are utilizing. They are all the resources, correct?
Yes.
If that all the resources are not getting 100% utilized, then can we say the optimal performance of the resources is not 100%? Yes or no? If all the resources are getting utilized, we can say there is 100% utilization?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, sir.
But if all not getting utilized, only the 30 or 40% getting utilized, then we cannot say the 100% utilization, and we can say we are not getting the optimal performance out of the resources available within that particular software industries. Then is that nothing but the loss for that company? Correct?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
You can take the example of our department also. In our department, suppose there are the 150 PCs are there. Correct. And out of that 150 PCs, only 100 are getting utilized. And they are also being utilized only during the day. Then remaining 50 are nothing but unutilized. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So that is the point I am trying to tell you. To reduce the rising cost, it is required to increase the ROI of the existing resources. Correct? What I'm saying? To reduce the rising cost, it is required to increase the ROI. ROI means what? Here I have written. ROI.
Return on investment.
Now what investment you have done? For example, what software company investment has done? Their available resources, their available resources are nothing but their investment. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then if the available existing resources will get 100% utilized, correct? If available resources get 100% utilized, that is nothing but increase ROI. Yes or no? जे काही रिसोर्सेस तुमच्या कंपनीमध्ये अवेलेबल आहेत ते सगळे जर 100% त्याचं युटिलायझेशन होत असेल बिकॉज फ्रॉम दॅट वी कॅन से द रिटर्न ऑन द इन्व्हेस्टमेंट इज गुड और रिटर्न ऑन द इन्व्हेस्टमेंट इज इन्क्रीजिंग. येस ऑर नो?
येस.
अँड इफ एक्झिस्टिंग रिसोर्सेस आर गेटिंग युटिलाइज 100%, then is there need of adding some new resources within your software company?
Yes, sir.
What I'm asking, if available existing resources are sufficient and all are getting utilized 100%, is there need to add new resources to the company?
No.
No. If you add new resources to the company, even existing are available, that is nothing but what? Rising cost. Yes or no? Correct.
Yes.
If 150 PCs are available in our department, still our department trying to purchase 20 PCs for any reason, then that is nothing but the rising cost. Yes or no?
Yes.
Correct. So to reduce the rising cost, it is required to increase the return on the investment. It is required to increase the return on the investment. Meaning of that point is what? It is required to make the better utilization and maximum utilization of available existing resources. If the existing resources are get utilized 100%, then definitely the rising cost will not happen. And to control these increasing cost or the rising cost, that is nothing but the second important challenge faced by information system manager. Understood this point?
Yes.
Yes. Now what can be done? Now there are the different ways. Okay, what we are discussing, second challenge being faced by the information system manager, that is the rising cost. Now we have understood what is meant by the rising cost, then the how the rising cost can be controlled. One of the way of controlling the rising cost is nothing but what? To increase the return on the investment, means try to do the maximum utilization of available existing resources of your company. Now there are the different methods related with increasing the return on investment, okay, using the existing resources. And in that, first one is nothing but conducting the survey of various department. Okay, first method to increase the return on the investment is what? To conduct the survey of department. Now, for what purpose to conduct the survey of the department? Yes. What do you mean by the conducting the survey of department? Yes, Suraj. What do you mean by the conducting the survey of department? Now in the company, there are different department are there. Consider the software company having the different department. Yes. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now what do you mean by the conducting the survey of the department, and for what purpose to conduct the survey?
Sir, finding the problem and
finding the problem with the existing resources. Correct.
Yes, sir.
And try to find out the solution related with the existing resources if they are not working. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Understood. So if that problem get identified, then within the existing resources, we can do some maintenance, and that existing resources can be bring into the utilization. Yes or no? Correct?
Yeah.
So for that purpose, the first method that is being utilized to increase the return on the investment is nothing but conducting the survey of various department and identify what are the problems with the existing resources. Now, existing resource can be a computer, can be a laptop, can be a software, can be any other softwares also, any other software tools also, etc., etc. So conducting the survey of the various department and try to identify what are the problems, and can using the maintenance only without adding too much cost, just doing some maintenance, whether it is possible to make that existing resources runnable, that is nothing but the purpose of conducting the survey of the department. If doing some updation within the existing system, okay, within some existing software, if there is no need to purchase some new system or the new software, then that point the information system manager is controlling the rising cost. Yes or no? Correct? Yes.
Yes, sir.
You understand how the conducting the survey of the department can help to control the rising cost?
Yes.
कधी कधी काय होतं की एखादी सपोज आपण आता लॅपटॉप ऍज अ एक्झिस्टिंग रिसोर्स एक्झाम्पल जर घेतलं, इफ देर इज अ सम मायनर प्रॉब्लेम इन द लॅपटॉप, सम एम्प्लॉई सेज दिस लॅपटॉप इज नॉट वर्किंग, ही नीड द न्यू सिस्टीम ऑर द न्यू लॅपटॉप. And if the certain company allow him to purchase the new laptop or give, he need not to purchase, company has to give him the laptop or the system or whatever he want to do the work. Correct. But by doing some updation or by doing some maintenance of the existing resource, if it is becoming ready to work, then definitely purchasing of the new resource is not required. And if no new resource not get purchased, definitely there is a decrease in the rising cost. Yes or no?
Sir.
Yes. So do you understand the first method too? Now, if information system manager is not allowing to increase the cost, means he is increasing the return on investment. Correct or not? Yes.
Yes, sir.
If information system manager not allowing to purchase new resource, not allowing in the sense he is ready to make some changes in the existing resource and he is ready to make it runnable so that employee can work on that system or employee can use that resource instead of purchasing new, is there cost cutting or not?
Yes, sir.
And yes. If there is a cost cutting, definitely that effect of that is nothing but increase in the ROI. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this is the first method that can be utilized by the information system manager to control the rising cost. Okay, let's see the next one. Another method using which the rising cost can be controlled, that is nothing but the getting the clear definition of the problem. Yes. What do you mean by getting the clear definition of the problems? Now, what happens sometimes within a company, new employee who are being recruited within a company and they have given some project to complete. Okay. Sometimes new employee or the new recruited employee can't able to do the, what you can say, can't able to find the solution which is required to complete that software. Or he might be facing some problem in the coding also. Understood. Sometimes it happens. But if that employee does not contact with his manager related with the problem he is facing, will that problem will get solved?
No, sir.
No. If he doesn't contact with his colleagues, project team members, manager, etc., etc., and he just pass the time, is it the beneficial for that company?
No, sir.
If he pass the time, then what will happen? Product delivery time will also get increased, correct?
Yes, sir.
And all these things happening because of what? That newly recruited employee not getting the clear definition of problems means not getting what actually he has to do, correct?
Yes, sir.
And that yes, is, sir. And if that employee communicate with his manager and ask him, dear sir, these things has to be done and I could not able to do this, please guide me. Then manager or his team members can guide him, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Because of that, passing of the time will get reduced.
Yes.
And because of that, return on the investment also get increased, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Time is also one resource for the software companies or for anybody, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And that is nothing but second method that can be utilized by the information system manager to increase the return on investment, and that's why also reducing the rising cost. Okay. Third important method being applied by the information system manager to reduce the rising cost is nothing but looking for a way to integrate. Means what? What do you mean by the integrate? Looking for a way to integrate is very good approach applied by the information system manager to control the rising cost. Yes, can you just think on this? Doing the integration with the existing system. I'm giving you the one clue. Doing the integration with the existing system and develop the solution. Yes. Do you understand what I'm asking? Looking for a way to integrate, one of the method to control the rising cost. Okay, let me tell you the example. XYZ software company is there, correct? Or any industry is there, we consider the software company only. That software company from the last 5 years, XYZ software company from last 5 years, they are utilizing the information system. Okay. Do you got the situation?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. XYZ software company is there. From last 5 years, that XYZ software company is utilizing the information system. And now they feel, some of the persons from the that company feels, now this existing information system need to get replaced with the new information system. Got the point? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Whatever the information system they are using from the last 5 years, some of them feel now this old information system, we need to replace with the new information system. Now, replacing the old information system with the new information system, that is the one point, clear? And doing the upgradation and the changes within an existing information system, out of these two options, which option is most beneficial for that company?
Second, upgradation.
upgradation and doing some changes within an existing information system is nothing but the most profitable or most beneficial option for that company. Because what happened, if you go for the new information system, you have to pay the full cost, correct?
Yes, sir.
But yes, sir. If it is possible to do the upgradation within an existing system only, then whether the full cost has to be given?
No.
No. Upgradation la full cost lagel ka?
Nahi.
Nahi. That is the point, is nothing but the doing the integration of old existing system with some modification and the changes and getting the that upgrade or updated information system, and which will affect what? Effect of that will what? The budget will increase or the decrease? This new solution that you have got by updating the existing information system, will it require the more budget?
No.
So you are getting the solution for your problem without increasing the budget, correct or not?
Yes.
And if the budget is not getting, the rising cost will be controlled or not?
Of course it controls.
Of course it will get control. And that is nothing but the important role being performed by the information system manager related with the rising cost. Understood this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then we have the last challenge being faced by the information system manager, that is related with the insufficient sensitivity considering the data security. Okay. The way data and the information processing within a company by using that information system increases, also what we can say, the security of that particular security challenge need to be controlled in good manner. What happened? Complexity of electronic data processing increases, the security often decreases. Understood? Means what? There is some lapses or the some some kind of interfere with your information system can be get increase during the utilization of your information system. And that is the reason the data which is available or the information which is available on your information system, its security, that is also the most important challenge being faced by the information system manager. Okay. Now what can be done? What can be done to increase the data security or the information security of your information system? First thing that can be done from the smart IT manager is nothing but what? It should tell their employees what is actually the importance of information and the data which is available within our information system. Yes or no? Correct?
Yes, sir.
If the employee of the your company who are utilizing that information system, if they are not serious about data and information available within an information system, then will the security of that information available on the information system will be maintained? Definitely not. So first important thing is what? The information system manager must increase the awareness of their employees towards the data security or the information security of the information which is available on the information system. Okay. And most of the companies nowadays focusing, most of the healthcare companies and the financial organization from the US government and from the different countries are trying to make this particular information system security proof by deploying various kind of protection measures, etc. etc. Now, simple thing can be done from the information system manager related with the security of the information system and the data which is available on the information system. Is that here I have mentioned the one point to help the other employee within your organization and understand how sensitive certain data is. A certain site pages can be attached when the employee is working on certain project. Understood? So there different kind of security measures can be put in the can be put into the place through the various kind of utilization of the you can say the antivirus system, firewall system. These kind of different kind of security measures can be taken. But important thing here related with the information or the data which is available on the information system is what your employee must be aware of all these kind of things. Your employee must be know if they try to share the information which is available on the information system, what can be its consequences on the company? Yes or no? Yes. Consequences means what? Consequences, I already told you what is the meaning of consequences. Yes, Suraj, consequences.
Parinam.
It can be what can be a bad effect of certain things, that is we are calling as a consequences. Now, bad effect can come when certain security procedures not get followed by your employee of your company. Understood? That is the point I'm trying to tell you. Your information system manager must make your employee aware of all these things, like what is the importance of information and the data which is available on the information system. Okay. There must be a certain, as here I have mentioned, site page explaining. Site page explaining means what? Suppose some employee working in their company, okay, by utilizing that information system, there must be some site pages. On these pages, various kind of things must be written, like related with the security of the information system, whom to contact if certain issue related with the information system comes, whom to contact related with the solution of security of information system, etc., etc. What security measures to be utilized to make your information system secure? All these things must be told by the information system manager to all the workers who are working in that company related with the utilization of information system. Then and then only your information system can remain secure proof. Yes or no? Yes.
Yes, sir.
And that is nothing but the third challenge being faced by the information system manager. That is the maintaining the security of information system by utilizing the various ways. So these are the three important challenges being faced by the information system manager. Which is the first one? First challenge?
Tough data flow.
Managing the tough data flow. That is what? Managing the analyzing, evaluation, controlling of the information with the help of the information system. Second challenge is what?
Rising cost.
Controlling the rising cost, that we have discussed how you can control the rising cost with the help of the different ways. And last one is what?
Insufficient sensitivity.
In short, security or the security of the data or information which is available on the information system. This is the 8-mark question being asked number of times for it can be also asked for the 4 marks also. Okay. All of you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Already I told you, I am not taking the attendance every day. And I already told you how I am going to consider the attendance. Okay. Now I cannot give you the any kind of assignment and all these things. Okay. So homework for you is nothing but you need to watch the video. Okay, whatever video I am uploading, and you need to mention there your name and the roll number. These things already I told you. When I finish this unit, only the 2 points, that is the case studies, are remaining. After that, I will mark the attendance of these whatever lectures I have taken. Up till I have not marked the attendance, correct? So I will mark the attendance from the that how many of you have seen the video and how many of you have entered your name and the roll number there. Understood? And that is also the your homework also. Got the point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so do that activity before I mark the attendance. Still, we will need the two lectures to finish the remaining part, that the two case studies are remaining. Correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Any doubt related with the today's part?
No, sir.
Okay, you just go through.